Welcome to the fourth session of the fourth module. In the previous module, we just discussed about different types of joining processes in which we have discussed soldering, brazing, and we have also discussed the welding processes. These three processes have got their own importance in the field of electronics, in the field of mechanical, and even in the field of the domestic applications. So before I just proceed about the differences between the soldering, brazing and welding, it's important to know on what basis the soldering and the brazing or the welding is been carried out. So quickly speaking, first we just discussed about the soldering, wherein which the tin and the lead mixed filler material. It's a wire like a filler material is being used over here, and in this soldering we will use a steel pointer which will be greatly heated. The filler material which is made up of a lead and tin will have a very low melting point of 50 to 150 degrees centigrade, wherein which it will be welded. By making that filler material into the molten state and with the wax of a zinc will be used in order to make a firm fit, and this is mainly used in the joining of the electronic equipments and the wire corrections. To sum up, actually the soldering is been used to join the electronic parts, and it is used to make electrical connections, whereas the brazing is been used to join dissimilar metals using a filler rod. But the major disadvantage over here in this brazing is the welded portion or the brazed portion can be identified very easily, so it doesn't gives a good aesthetic effect. Now when it comes to the welding process, in the welding process what happens, a similar metals at a very high temperature is been used for conversion or joining the metals. The major advantage here in the welding process is the joined material looks as a single piece. That is the beauty of this welding. And even in this welding also we have got two types of major welding processes. One is the pressure welding, and the other one is a fusion welding. In the pressure welding, actually what we will do is we will heat the joining interface, that is the layer, the materials at this intersection. We will heat this intersection to the plastic state, and then we will make the joints by the external application of the pressure. Is it clear? Next we will go for the fusion welding, wherein which the same interface or the joining intersection will be melted to a position to a temperature of 300 to 500 degrees centigrade, where degrees centigrade, where in a molten state we will heat it up, these two interactions, and then we will, without the external pressure, we will join this process, join these two metals pieces. So that is the idea behind of the welding. Okay, in the brazing process what happens, the filler material is filled into the tight fitting joint through a capillary action. However, in brazing welding, the filler material is deposited in many ways other than the capillary action. Even when you come to this welded and the soldered difference, welding will have a more stronger joint compared to the soldering or brazing. Like many sheet metals terms, soldering and welding are used as an interchangeably. The main, when it comes to the major difference between welding and soldering, it is its melting. In soldering, metal fabricators heat the metal to be bonded, but never melt them. In soldering, it just happens. In welding, what happens? Metal fabricators melt the base material itself, then it will be joined. Basically what happens, if you ask me, the soldering as strong as the welding? No, it is not at all. But what happens when it comes to the electric connections, we cannot go for a welding process, wherein which it will say, for example, if you take a motherboard or any circuit board, which is all made up of a very lightweight material, if we go for welding, the complete sheet itself will get melted up in within no time. And more of in welding, what happens, the electrically conductible materials will be welded, isn't it? Now, what happens, different metals can be soldered. Metals that can be soldered including a gold, silver, copper, brass and iron, anything. The bond created when the melted soldered material solidifies, not as strong as the welding or a brazing. No, actually among all, the weakest one is a soldering, whereas the strongest one is a welding. In between the soldering and welding, the strength of the weld that is being made up of with the soldering comes. In the increasing order, soldering, then brazing, then the strongest will be the welding joint. Okay, as a soldered bond is not as strong as welded or a brazed one, and because of it is not been a mechanical connection. That is the one advantage of the welding processes. Now let us, if you see this, a column where the welding in which a high temperature process wherein the base metals are heated above their melting temperature, whereas in a soldering, the soldered low temperature process with the base materials are being melted. So when it comes to the brazing way of joining the materials, the base metals are not melted but only broadly heated to a suitable temperatures. So this is one of the major technical difference between a welding, soldering and the brazing. Whereas here in the welding, what happens, the temperature process wherein the base metals will be heated to a minimum of a plastic state, whether it may be even in the irrespective of the welding types, whether it may be arc welding or it may be oxyacetylene, any welding it may be, whether it is a pressure welding or a non-pressure or a fusion welding, or it may be a resistance welding, or it may be TIG welding, what may be MIG welding. Okay, now any process it may be, the base metal will be heated to a very high melting temperature. That is a one plus point. Whereas in a soldering, it is a low temperature process. Base metals are being connected, and even in the soldering, we cannot go for a longer welding processes. Say for example, if you take a bus, the bus roof and the side roof has to be welded. Basically, they will go for a TIG welding, but you cannot go for a soldering or a brazing itself. Is it clear? In brazing, what happens? The base metals are not melted, that is true, but broadly heated to a suitable temperature. The heat ranges, even brazing, lies between soldering and welding, wherein the soldering it is 50 to 150 degrees Celsius, and even in the welding it is around 3000 to 5000 degrees Centigrade. Is it clear? So in that cases, what happens, the brazing always lies between more than 150 degrees Centigrade and less than the welding temperatures, but it will be suitably it will be heated. That is the reason why you might see this brazing most popularly in domestic applications. If the vessels have been found some hole, they will patch it up. So such kind of things will be done effectively in the brazing process. Okay, in the welding process, what happens, filler metals used is of the same material as that of the base metal. Whatever, if the steel is being used, if the steel joints have been used or has to be joined, then the filler material will be made up of the same material, same of the steel only. That is why it doesn't look as a different material. It makes it to appears to be the same material even after the building. Then the filler material is not same as that of the base metal. It is only because, say for example, if you have two wires, this is a wire and this is a, because this is a copper. Okay, now copper, two wires has to be joined, so the filler material cannot be the same thing. In the soldering, what they will do is, the filler material will be remain same, that is, which is made up of lead and tin, which has got low melting point. So irrespective of the metal or the material of that we are going to solder it, the filler material same for all the material. Okay, now filler filler material is not the same as that of the base material even in the brazing also. Only in case of welding it will be same. That is the reason why. However, the soldering cannot be seen because it will be there inside the cabin. Say for example, even if you take a mobile or if you take a TV or a laptop or a computer, if you see, open it and see, the electric circuit board is always found with a silver color line dots. This silver color line dots are nothing but the soldered one. Is it clear? Whereas in a brazing that you can see it, even if you take a vessel, if there is any dot, they will patch it up with a brazing applications. That can be seen. That makes a difference. Since the filler material is not same as the base material, you can find the places where the brazing has been done. Well, that is absent in case of welding. In the welding, joint is formed by the solidification of the molten filler metal with molten base metal. Okay, that means joint that is being formed, the solidification of the filler material which will be in a liquid state, and even the place where we are going to weld it in the section also, in the cross section also, the same molten metal. So what we will do it is, we will fill it up this filler material. Since this material and the filler material it is the same, it will mix us up with this and the molten base metal will be formed. Joint is formed by the means of diffusion of the filler metal into the base metal. Whereas here we are just diffusing the filler metal into the base material. Then the filler joint is been formed by means of diffusion of the filler metal into the base metal associated with surface alloying. Okay, that is the only difference between soldering, brazing and the welding. Strength. When it comes to the strength, obviously, as I have already told you, the strength of the welded joint is much stronger than the compared to the soldering and brazing. And in addition to that, the strength of the weld joint will also be much joint than the base material. That means, if you take this is a base material, this is the one base material and this is the other base material, and I'm going to weld this like this and I'm going to join this. Now if you consider this, what he means to say that is, if you consider the strength of this weld with the base material, this weld material will be much stronger than the base material. Is it clear? That is the major plus point of the welding. The strength of the soldered joint is comparatively low. Whereas in comes to the brazing, the strength of the brazed joints lies between that of the welded and soldered. As I have already told you, when it comes to the strength of the weld three joint, the lowest strength is for the soldering, and the second one it is for the brazing, and next it is for the welding process. Highest strength is from the welding and the lowest strength is for the soldering. Is it clear? Now, since the welding takes place at high temperatures, the metal adjacent to the weld portion called heat affected zone is affected to a large extent. Now, as I have already told you, once again, I just show you over here. Now, if you can see this is a one material and this is the other material and this is a weld. This is a welding that is being carried out with the blue color. Now, since it will be heated to a very high temperature. No, my dear friend, please be careful. This is been in a fusion, say for example, if you consider this as a fusion welding. So this will be a molten metal. So what happens, the area which is being surrounded by these two, by this welding on both the sides, will be affected in a larger extent. That means this will experience more or less equal temperature. If this is at around 2000 degrees centigrade, this will also be at the 2000 degrees centigrade. So the temperature will affect, the weld temperature will affect the surrounding or the what we call it as the heat affected zone. Heat affected zone will be affected greatly to a larger extent by this addition of heat. That is the reason why we always go with quoting also, but still, however, we cannot avoid certain things. It has to experience it. Is that clear? Because it is a metal and it is a good conductor of heat, so that will be affected. Now, now there is no such kind of heat affected zones, which will not greatly influenced by this solder. There is no heat affected zone as the process is carried at lower temperatures. So this doesn't affect much on the soldering areas. Although the base metals are heated, the heat affected zone is not too much when compared to the welding. It will be affected in brazing also, to be frank. What happens if this is, say, for example, now this is a material and there is a hole. If I want to fix this, if I want to weld this or braze it, the area which has been surrounded by this will also influence, will also affect it, but not up to that level, because the brazing has the temperature limits between soldering and the welding, and the temperature is not up to that welding, so the heat affected zone will not be influenced by this heat. Okay, it lies between that. Okay, now a welded joint requires certain finishing operations like grinding and filling, etc. Filing, I'm sorry. Grinding and filing. No, as I have already told you, what happens when we have a welding, a welded like this, a welding zone like this. So what happens, this will be protruded. This will come a little above this base surfaces. The weld, are you getting my point? This weld will come above the surface levels of the neighboring two pieces. So what happens, this has to be filed, because we want to make it as a single piece. So we have to go for a filing, or we have to go for a grinding. Whenever it is a minor thing, then we will go for a filing. Whenever large amount of material has been accumulated over there, then we will go for grinding process. Grinding is nothing but a wheel will be there, and we just remove a material in a small quantity and make this to appear as a single piece like this. Is it clear? So that is a requirement. But in soldering and brazing, it doesn't comes into picture at all, because just the soldering, see, first and foremost thing is soldering is, we are just, it is something like a point welding or a spot welding. Is it clear? Only at certain points, say for example, I'll take two wires and I will join it in a circuit board. So that's it. We are not going for a continuous soldering process, because it is not so strong as welding. It is weaker. Joints can be used as is without any finishing operations. That is the reason. In some cases, brazed joints require finishing operations when it is being exposed outside surfaces. Certain occasions only they will go for that, and even I don't think the brazing will have a higher rate of metal accumulations, so that will always stay back, and only a filing may be sufficient time. Okay, now the another technical difference is in a welding procedure, stronger joints have been formed, whereas in the soldering it is comparatively weak. Whereas in brazing it is used as arts, jewelry works, and in some industries also. So what happens, because it is of a stronger joints in welding, the process used for fabrication and structural applications, this has been extensively used. Welding applications, it is extensively used in fabrication and structural applications. Fabrication and structural applications, we will use it. Whereas here in the soldering, now you can see many applications, even your benches or a desk where you sit in the classroom. Apart from that, wooden, whatever the mechanical joints, if it breaks, or it may be a cot, or it may be a chair, anything, it will give a structural load. Now even just imagine, if you have a chair with four wheels, if one is broken out, and we will join this with the welding, and you can sit and dance on that. It is only, I just want to tell you that it is such a strong joint that it can take more load. if you see the soldering, you can pluck it off. You can pluck it off the wires which have been soldered by hand itself. Whereas in welding, it is not. And more of the point is, the welded portion will be much, much stronger than the base material. See the beauty. That is the reason why they will always use for fabrication and structural application. This is what I mean to say. Structural application means, even if you see the roofs, if you see these roofs, everything, the truss elements, on the roof where in which you can see this hash like structures which will be given supporting. So those things are all been welded, and even the compounds, gates, everything is been welded because of its strength and the load bearing capacity. Is it clear? That is the applications of welding. When it comes to the soldering, soldering has been used only in the light capacity, the lightweight capacities, where joining of the wires in the circuit boards and even in the toys. That's it. Is it clear? And when it comes to the brazings, brazing has got its own applications in some industries and jewelry works. Okay, so that is the applications. This is the major difference. We can also give much more, many more differences, but I just have given the technical differences. The technical differences between a welding, soldering and brazing. My dear friends, if you have understood the principle of working of a soldering and brazing and welding, no need to remember all these things. Automatically you can make out the points and you can write down how many points you can write down. So basically the more importance will be given for the differences which highlights the technical aspects. Is it clear? That is the one thing. And even here also you can write down the filler material will be of so and so, and the filler material which is made up of, okay, there will be a slag and coating will be there, where we are not using any coating, but we will be using a flux in the brazing and in the soldering. Whereas here we are just having a flux coating, whereas here there is no flux coating for the filler materials, right? So that is all there. When it comes to the application based areas, welding is something which takes more load in mechanical applications. Soldering is mainly in the electronics, electricals and computer science applications. Now let us go to the belt drives. Before I just go to the belt drives, I just want to tell you the importance of the belt drives. Basically, a belt is nothing but a loop of a flexible material. It's a loop. That means it is a continuous one. It has been a continuous one. Say for example, it will be circular. It is a continuous one. So it is a loop of some flexible material. It can be made up of leather, or it can be made up of cloth, or it can be made up of some threads or whatever it may be. And so different materials are used based on the application. If you go for a floor mill, the belts are made up of cloth. Whereas when you go for a car applications or in the automobile applications, they have been made up of with a very good leather material. Okay, so based on some applications they will use it, but belt is an it's a loop. It's been a loop, okay, with a flexible material to link two or more rotating shafts mechanically. It's a shaft. A shaft is nothing but a rotating element. That is what we call it as a shaft. If anything which is rotating, don't ask me about this fans or anything else. The one cause or the one reason which is majorly related or generates the rotation is nothing but a shaft or a rotating shaft. Okay, from a link between two or more rotating shafts mechanically. That means physically they will transfer it. Mechanically, physically they will be in touch, and mechanically they will transfer the motions from one to the other. Most often a parallel or even the cross tools will be there. Most of the applications they will use a parallel. I just shall come to that later. Best belts may be used as a source of motion to transmit the power effectively and efficiently, or to track the relative movement. That is the use of the belt drives. Actually, Even in the belt drives also, we classify it into open belt drive, clock, closed or crossed belt drives. We also call it as a forked and loose pulley, loose cone pulley drives, and we also categorize that into stepped cone pulley. Then we also use a jockey pulleys or a jockey pulley drive also, we call it as. Okay, now these belts will may be around, say for example, you must be remember when we used to take the water from the well, we always use a rope and we will take it, right? So that rope was in circular or in a round shape, and V belts are also there, flat belts are also there, and even timing or toothed belts are also there. We will go to that later on. So the different types of belt have been there. Then we also use the other belt drives also, which have been made up of one of the most common devices in the belt drives are used to transmit the motion from one shaft to the other shaft with the help of a thin inextensible band that runs over two pulleys, and it should be flexible enough. Why? Because the belt will always experiences more compression and expansion, compression and expansion. Okay, that is the reason why we always go with that actually. Now basic principle, if you ask me, it is based on a simple belt pulley system, consists of a driver pulley and it may be a driven pulley. A driver pulley is the one which will be rotating, and the other driven pulley is one which is not rotating. If you want to make this to make the other pulleys also rotating, then you have to join these two with a belts. Not only belt, if you want to transmit the power, you can also go for a gears, you can also go for a chain. Say for example, if you have a bicycle, when you pedal it, when you are pedaling, it is a rotary motion, and that rotary motion has to be transmitted to your back wheels. How do you will transmit? No, when you are pedaling, there will be one small sprocket will be there, a sprocket like this. It turns tara irutala, itara sprockets irutte. And even in the back wheels, if you observe, there will be one more disc will be there with the sprockets. So what happens, a chain will be connected between the pedaling sprockets as well as the back wheels, so that what happens, how much ever you pedal it, the same rotary motion will be transmitted towards the back wheels. That is the same idea. There we use a chain, and here we use a belt, because it drives. The one which is rotating independently is called as a driving pulley or a driver pulley. Driving or a driver or anything. And the one which takes the load is called as a driven pulley. In your bicycle, your pedaling is a driver pulley. Your back wheel is a driven pulley. Is that clear? When driver pulley is rotated, it causes pulling action due to friction. And this pulley affects the rotate the driven pulley in the same direction as. Okay, now what happens if you are moving in a forward direction, or it may be in a clockwise direction, even this also rotates in the same directions. Then if you use a different directions, if you want to cross it, say for example, I am rotating in a clockwise direction, I want the wheel to rotate in an anti-clockwise direction, then we will go for cross belt drives. Okay, now if you the belts can be made up of a different materials, something like major five materials are there. The conveyor belts may be made up of a thermoplastics, it may be made up of metals, rubber, fabric and leather. Plastics include polyester, polyvinyl chloride, silicone and polyethylene. The metals are stainless and carbon steels, and the fabric materials have been canvas and cotton. Canvas is something like a hard, like our jeans material, it will be there. So the canvas, or it may be made up of canvas, cotton. So I just I'll tell you the different materials that has been used for the belt material. It can be made up of the rubber or the thermoplastics, metals, or it may be made up of fabric or leather, and even including the plastic materials, which are polyester, polyvinyl chloride and silicon, and then polyethylene, which are very flexible in nature, which helps us to have a flexible in the belt drives. Okay. So, to transmit power from one shaft to the another, pulleys are been mounted on two shafts. The pulleys are then connected to the endless belt, or it may be we call it as a loops. Loop are nothing but an endless belts passing over the pulleys. The connection between the belt is being kept in tension so that the motion of the one pulley is being transferred to the other without any slippage. Slippage is nothing but if you have this rotating shaft, if I have a belt, it should not slip. It should not slip. So there should be enough. Now you just imagine why is the slipping, all those things occurs when the belt is not perfectly fitted between two shafts. That is what. Now there are different two types of belt ties are there, open and the cross belt ties, that we shall discuss in the